night. I'm ready to paint. Been outside all afternoon after I got back from seeing Smokey. Carrie and I were bleaching shirts because it was a bright sunny day, and she makes these shirts that she has to bleach herself. And so we were out in the backyard in the sunshine bleaching those shirts, getting ready for her to make them this week. So now I'm inside and painting. It won't be long, and I can go back outside painting again on my patio. I just love to paint outside. So much better than inside. But I'm still inside for right now. And tonight, I'm painting this Easter egg wheelbarrow. It's a big one. You can see how big he is. He's a big old boy. But he'll show up good in your yard. And he's real easy to paint. He's fun. There's lots of different egg combinations that you can do up here at the top. Use all those pretty spring colors. And you can't go wrong with any color combination because there's so many eggs. I did my wheelbarrow white. I like a white wheelbarrow. I think it shows up good against your dead greenery that we've got now in front of our yards. Unfortunately, looks like everything's going to be dead, and we're going to have to have it all pulled up. But the white's going to show up against your brick of your house or against your dead foliage if you're lucky enough to have some foliage still green. Looks like maybe the waxleaf ligustrums are about the only thing that really did not freeze. I'm going to have to let my dog out because he's in his cage and he's barking. But this is what we're going to paint tonight. So I'm going to put it down and I'll show you the paint colors that I used and the brushes, and then we'll get started. I used most all of our light colors. I used, of course, black and white, which is our number 35 is white. And I used that for the wheelbarrow itself. And then the shading on the wheelbarrow, I used gray, number 24. Now, buddy, I'm not going to put up with that. We'll see if he's going to be quiet or not. And then I used black for my outlining, and black is number 37. And I put it in a little cup and watered it down. Then I used, for my eggs, coral, number 15. And I used light pink, number 25. Light yellow, number 13. Mint green, number 9. Light blue, number 2. Sky blue, number 1. Light purple, 27. Shading pink, 26. And reindeer brown, I used for my wheel. I wanted my wheel to be wood looking. So I used reindeer brown, number 32. And shading brown, number 34. So those are the colors I used. But you could easily use seafoam green as part of your eggs. You could use, what other color is light that I didn't use? I shaded with teal, and I forgot to tell you about teal. Teal, number 7, I did some shading with teal. I think that's all of the colors that I used. I base coated, and I sprayed white first so that my MDO was covered with white. A base coat. And I do that when I have a lot of area of white, because then the white covers good and light colors will cover good. After that, I put two colors, two co- coats of base coat on there to get nice even colors. The brushes that I use, I did a dry brush technique. So I used my sturdy old worn out oil paint brush that's real stiff, that's not even really good and clean. And that's what I use for dry brushing. You just need an old brush that is stiff. You want it to be stiff. You could use a stenciling brush, but I think Ashley uses a chip brush that's real cheap that has kind of frayed ends on it. But any kind of stiff brush, you want it to be stiff. You don't want the bristles to be soft. And that's what I use to do my dry brushing with. And I'm going to do the dry brushing first, so I'll be using this one first. Then mop brushes or any of the square brushes. I used a, let's see, this is a number 12 shader and a number, both of these are 12, but you can see one of them is bigger than the other one. Different brush companies will have different sizes, but they're basically about a half inch square brush. Then I use some mop brushes, and they have nice points on them for my eggs. So one's an 8 and one's a 10. And then my script liner that is the number 6 script liner. And I used it to do all of my lining for my CNC lines. Then I also have one of the little pouncers to do my polka dots. And it's one of the little small pouncers. So those are the brushes that I use. And the first thing I'm going to do is the dry brushing so that it can dry. And you can see how I do the dry brushing, and then it's going to dry while I shade my eggs. I'm going to have to stomp me some dogs here if they don't quit barking. I sent the big dog over to Carrie's so that she wouldn't bark. She's been barking all afternoon. People have been outside, and she just can't stand it when they're outside, and she's not outside. All right, I'm going to dry brush my white first. So I'm going to get my gray, and I'm just going to barely dip it in the gray. I'm not going to get much paint on there at all. Set that over the side. Then I've got a paper plate and a paper towel, and I'm going to pounce most of it off. Then I'm going to come in on this upper part of the wheelbarrow here. I want that to stand up. So I'm going to make my strokes going up, going vertically. And I don't care if there's much on there, but I want those to go vertically. So I'm just putting a little bit of dry brushing just right on going vertically on that part. I'm going to do the same thing. I'll reload the brush. But I just tapped it on this paper towel that I already had some paint on. I didn't go back in the paint at all. And then these legs, I want to do vertical on these legs. A little bit more paint. Buddy, you better hush. Okay, coming up vertical. And then there's a little round button here that's like your screw. I'm going to go the opposite direction and get a little dry brush on it. So I've got both of my legs with vertical dry brush. Now I want horizontal dry brush on all the rest of the wagon. Because I've got these cut lines from the CNC that make the grain of the wood, so I want to go along horizontally all along, and again, not much paint, just a suggestion of some gray in here. Just dry brushing just a little bit, and because this brush is old and it's stiff, it's just putting down just a little bit of paint. And it's real sketchy looking paint. It's dry. That's what dry brushing is, when you don't have much paint on there. And I don't want a lot of paint. And I'm going to come inside where these circles are for these knot holes. And that's about all I want on there. Pretty just about that much. Now, while I've got this brush out, I'm going to put the lid back on my gray. And I'm going to clean it just slightly. Not going to clean it real good. I just tapped it in the water. And I don't want it very wet, so I'm tapping most of that water out. I'm going to take my shading brown, and I'm going to dry brush my wheel. Now, on this wheel, I put blue for the interior of the wheel here. You could use black to let that disappear so that you only see the spokes. I wanted sky, I guess you'd think, looking through there. You could put green, because if you're, it's going to be in your flower bed and you've got greenery behind it, you could put green. But this is the void between the spokes. Now, the CNC line is just one line, and I wanted this wider. So that's where I took that half-inch brush, and I made that spoke wider. You can have just a line and have it like it's a iron, a piece of iron or a piece of wire that's on the wheel, but I wanted mine to be wider, so I made that area wider. But I'm going to dry brush this with my shading brown, which is number 34. So I'm going to get some of my shading brown. I'm going to do the same thing. I'm just going to barely tap just a little bit of shading brown. Then I'm going to take my paper towel, and I'm going to get most of that off. And then I'm going to come in here and dry brush. First, I'm doing my spokes. Then I want these strokes to be circular. So I'm coming along the edge, and I'm following the circle for these dry brush strokes. So I'm letting them come around the circle to get some dry brush. And that's all the dry brush I want to do on that. So you just got just a little bit of dry brush. Now this is going to dry before I put on the next layer of shading for this. So I'm going to put this one down. Move it over here out of the way. This is a big piece, so it's harder to move around. And I've got this one that I already did that. So now since I have my shading brown, I'm going to go ahead with my shading brown, and I'm going to take one of my pointed brushes that they're kind of mop brushes, but they have a point. They're a round brush. And I'm going to come in with my shading brown, and I'm just going to shade around the outside edge and it can go a little bit of dry brush. I'm going to get the paint wet, but then as it flows off of my brush, if it becomes a little dry, that's okay too, because that'll blend in. So I'm coming along and I'm going to shade my wheel with this shading brown. And if it gets a little raw looking on the edge or a little rough, that's good, because then it'll just blend right in with that shading brown. So I'm kind of going back over it a little bit so it's not a hard line right around that outside. So I'm coming around, and right along, if I have a hard line, I'm kind of lightly going around and making that line a little bit softer by just brushing right on top of it. And my paint's almost off of my brush. I don't have much and it's picking up some that's still there that's wet. Now I'm going to come up and I'm going to go on both sides of my spokes. Hope y'all had a good day today. I thought the sun was so good to see the sun. I think we all feel better when we see the sun. My visit with Smokey was pretty good today. He was up in his wheelchair, which is unusual because a lot of times he's not up when I get there. So I was happy about that. He doesn't like to get up in his wheelchair. He'd rather just lay in bed. But he just gets weaker and weaker if he lays in bed. Okay, so here I've gone all the way around my wheel with that shading brown. And I'm going to let that dry. And then I'll add in, you know what I think I'm going to do though? While I still got the shading brown, I'm going to put a few just little thin lines like the grain of the wood. Just barely touching, letting the tip, very light strokes, letting the tip of the brush just kind of curl around. See those little lines I added? That's making it look more like wood. And then I'll come back in and I'll add my black after that's dry. So then I'm finished with my shading brown. So I'm gonna wash my brush out, and I'm gonna get my gray, because now I want to shade my wheelbarrow itself. This is dry up here, so I can put my hand on it. So I'm just going to basically outline all along my CNC lines. This is the top of my wheelbarrow. This is the little top of it. Along the edge of the wheel. So that I've got it like that. Now, because I've got it there, I'm going to go ahead with just the tip, and I'm just going to make a few heavier, just a few, not a lot, of little lines like they would be the grain of the wood. And I'm going to try to make them curve just slightly every once in a while so that I have just some little lines in there. Now I'm going to come down. I'll have to turn it around. And this part is so big. My table, I decided to use this smaller table. I thought maybe you all could see it a little better if I got it up higher and used this smaller table. I don't know if this is going to work out or not. I'm always working on a way to make it look a little better. First thing I'm going to do is this back leg. Now there is not a line across this back leg to let it be in the back, but it is the short leg that's behind. So I'm going to put a line across that, even though there's not one on the CNC. And then I'm going to add a few lines in there so that that back line right there, this back leg, starts to recede. I want to get it a little dark looking. So then I'm going to come along the bottom, all along the edge with my gray. And if it fades out a little bit on your brush, that's okay. That just helps add to it if you run out of paint on it. So I'll come along the bottom. And then this front leg, I'm going to come on the outside of that leg because I want that to look like it is protruding, like it's higher. So I want that shadow line. So I'm coming on the outside of that leg. And then I'm going to go around this little button, this little circle, which is where it attaches. It's a little screw, or you could make it into, I'm going to have it a little wooden peg. But I'm going around that circle. Then I'm going to come down and I want to do the sides of that leg and across the bottom. And then while I've got that leg just with the point, I'm going to trail down a few little curvy lines for some grain of my wood. Okay. Now I've got these CNC cut lines that are already there for you, so I'm going to go along those lines with my gray. Eventually, I'm going to put black in that line. That's my grain line, but I want it to be gray along the bottom of that line to give it some dimension. So I'm coming right along that line with my gray paint. Then I'm going to come up the side, or this is the back of the wheelbarrow, and along the handle. It's got two handles. And this is going along the top. And you can just ride your brush right along that CNC cut line. And then it comes, curves down around the wheel. And then you've got this button. Let me lift this up. Then you've got another one of these buttons that's cut into there. That's the axle, I guess you would say. So I'm coming around that. So now all I have left to do is to come with my gray right along these other CNC lines. And then this one is a little circle, like a little knothole. I'm going to start back here and trail my brush up and then curve it around. So it's not quite so abrupt. And the same thing with this one. Coming up here, get a little bit more paint on my brush. And curve it around. And then I've got this one that's at the top. And I'm going to lift up on my brush and just trail off ever so gently so that that line doesn't end abruptly, so that it trails off. So I've got all of the grain except for this top handle. I'll come up here and I'm just going to outline it with my gray. And then I want to put a couple of little, just light little lines in that. And I think I may add just a few trailing grain lines with the tip of my brush. Just a few. That's enough. Put my paint on it. So that's all that gray that I need. So you can see I've got all of that gray. It was dry brushed first, and then I did those gray lines for the shading. Now when this is dry, I'll come back in with my black, and I will go over my CNC lines with my black. So while that's drying, then we're going to talk about the eggs up here. Most of the eggs, I didn't do a lot extra. You've got two plain eggs. You've got a plain one here and a plain one there. The others all have designs on them. So if you just choose your colors and then you outline, that's really all you're going to have to do for those eggs. So let's work on this pink one right here first. So I'm going to have shocking pink. or shading pink. I want to call it shocking pink instead of shading pink because it's a really pretty hot pink color. And I like the color on it. So I'm going to take another round brush and I'm going to come up the side. I'm going to go around that polka dot. Across the front here. Around this polka dot. Paint really good with you sitting behind me. You all see he's gotten right here behind me. Yeah, I see you. He wants to help. That's Bo. Yeah, that's Bo. Yeah, you're Bo. I know. Okay, so I've got more pink over here. So while I've got my pink out, I'm just going to shade this part. And this pink one that's right here, I wanted a little different pink. So I think I told you once before, I had a little bit of shading pink left in this container. So I just added some white to it. So I got half white and half shading pink. And that's what that color is right there. But I'm almost out of it now. But I like that color a lot. So I may keep adding some more. But again, I'm just going to use my shading pink. For that one. And then this light pink one, I'm going to shade it with the shading pink. And once you just shade these, you really don't need to do anything else to them because they've got so much design already in them. With the stripes. I mean, you can put more pattern on those stripes if you want to. You can add more polka dots or stripes or checks or, you know, however you want to do it for that matter. But the eggs show up pretty good just like they are. Okay, so I've got that one shaded. Now just my little zigzag part here at the top of this one. That all shaded in. There's not a lot left. So that's my pink that I'm shading. So my shading pink is done. My coral, you could use shading pink on that coral, but I'm going to use red orange to shade it, I think. I think the red orange will really make that pop. So I'm going to use red orange for my coral colors. So I've got polka dots right here. So I'm going to shade those on the inside first. So I'm shading those polka dots on the inside. And I'm shading them pretty wide because I want a lot of color on that. So I'm doing a pretty wide shading. I'm bearing down on my brush and making it fan out to do quite a bit of shading on those. Then I'm going to come over here for this coral. And this egg is a little smaller because it's behind. So I'm not pressing down on my brush as much to get that shading line a little narrower. And those lines, you can use a smaller brush or you can just not put as much pressure on that brush. And then I'm gonna go on around the outside of that egg, that polka dot. And then my last piece of coral is right here on this egg, this little zigzag part. I hope you all have been into the store and seen all of the Easter blanks, because they're, I think they're exceptional this year. I really like all the crosses and the eggs, all the different eggs designs. I put my eggs out in my front yard already. I don't have all of my Easter stuff painted yet, but I've got a lot of it painted. Okay, let's see. On my yellow, I want my shading yellow, which is number 14. So I'm going to shade my yellow. So shading yellow, come up with this one. Come down to this one that's yellow, and I have to reach over, so I put my arm here and I rest my elbow on my fist to come over here, and I'm just using my wrist to put that in. So you can make a bridge. There's painting bridges that you can buy. You can just make a fist, put your arm on your fist, do the same thing. Okay, so my shading yellow is done. So see, my shading yellow, it's starting to come together. Okay, I'm going to do my mint green. And my mint green, let's see. I'm going to shade it with lime, number 10. It's a good color to shade with, for lime. Got lime right here, mint green to shade my lime. You could shade it with Christmas green, but I think that's a little harsh. I think this lime softens it a little bit, and we want spring colors that are soft. Okay, so there's my green that's shaded. Now my blues, I've got two blues in here. I've got sky blue right here, and then I've got my light blue. So I'm going to shade my light blue polka dots with my sky blue. And it's real subtle. There's not, you can't see a lot of shading. So I'm going to come around here and make a fairly wide shading with this, because I'm going to come back and I'm going to put some teal on top of it. It's like layering it. So then I'm going to come, I don't want to put it on this one because I've got light blue and teal here. So I'm going to come down and I'm going to do it on this one. And I'm going to make a fairly wide, I'm making that brush fan out quite a bit, and it's real subtle. You may not the video may not pick it up because these are the same values. They're just slightly different. But then when you put that teal on there, where is my teal? Here's my teal. I'm not even going to wash my brush out. Ooh, that needs shaking. So then I'm going to take my teal and I'm going to shade my polka dot here that's in my coral egg. And I'm going to come over here and shade this egg with teal. And I'm going to come around my polka dots to have extra shading to get extra color on those eggs. Now, I want to just use just the tip of the brush, and I'm going to come down here on this one, and I'm going to just get a little line of the teal, because I already have, and it's not dry enough, really, so I'm not getting that stripe I really want, because it's not quite dry enough to come back right now, but maybe you can see it enough, but it just makes an extra little stripe around these places where I used the sky blue. Just gives you just an added little color pop. So everything is shaded but my purple. And my light purple is going to be shaded with shading purple. So I need to wash my brush out. Get my shading purple. And it's a pretty dark color. So I don't want, I'm just tipping my brush in there. I'm not going to make a really big wide line of my shading purple because it's pretty dark. So I don't want a real dark because I like that lilac of the light purple color and I don't want to darken my eggs up. It's easy if you're when you're working with pastels of getting them too dark. Those are in, so I've got one more purple over here to shade. Okay, so all of my eggs are shaded. So now I put some polka dots. Let's see, I've got shading purple out. I'll use that. I used my little, where's my little pouncer deal? Ah, where'd he go? I had him out earlier. I'm gonna get one of these. I've got one of these little foam pounce brushes. So I'm going to tap it in the purple, and I don't want a lot on there, so I tap some of it off. So I'm just adding some polka dots to this plain egg that had no design on it. So I got some polka dots on that egg. Now so that this plain egg does not feel so lonesome, I'm gonna try this. I'm not gonna wash this off. I'm just gonna take a little bit of that one. And this may not be dark enough. Probably not. Nope, not gonna be dark enough. I'll come in here with my light. And I'm going to put some polka dots on this plain one too. There we go. Now these need to be washed off just like your brush, and you can keep using them. You just dip them in the water and then just pat them on your paper towel until you don't get any more paint off of them. And they last pretty long. You kind of be surprised at how long they will last. You can't get them completely clean. I mean, you could go over the sink and wash them with soap and water if you want to. But I just keep dipping them in my water and pouncing them off on a paper towel until I don't get much paint left on there. And then they come pretty clean. Okay, so now this needs to dry before I can start doing my black highlights. My wheel is just about dry, so I'm going to come down and I'll do a little bit of my black with my script liner. And I've got it already mixed up. And you have to decide what consistency you like. It's kind of personal preference. This is looking almost too thick. So I'm going to put a couple of drops more of water in. Let me stir that up. I like it like heavy cream. I want it to be thin enough that it doesn't skip on me, but it'll drag if you get it too wet. So I'm going to come right in that CNC line and just let my brush fill that CNC line up. And when you first start, you don't have enough really paint on your bristles of your brush, and it takes a little while before they get enough paint in there to cover in one stroke. And some of these CNC lines are deeper than the others. I don't know. I think sometimes when they're cutting, sometimes they go really deep and other times it's not quite as deep. So it kind of depends on the depth of that line. But just let that script liner go right in that CNC cut line, filling up. And if you go a little outside that line, that's fine. You don't have to be real worried about staying right in that line. But you do want plenty of paint down in that line. So sometimes I go over it two or three times even. Go one way and then go the opposite direction. And some of this is still not quite dry enough. I usually wait maybe 2 hours for my paint to dry. And then come back to do my script lining. And I dropped a little bitty piece, but it'll wipe right off while it's still wet. Spit works really good on it too. Now I'm going to take my script liner and I'm going to put some grain lines for my wheel because my wheel is wood too. So I'm going to add some lines along the edge so you can see how that's starting to look like wood. Okay, I'm going to stop because all I'm going to do from now on is just follow my CNC cut lines with my script liner and black. So I'm going to pick up my other one. And you can see I followed all of those lines. I added those lines in my white. I did the black lines, and then I didn't put very many black lines. I let my gray ones be my grain lines. Then I followed all these CNC lines around all my eggs. Then I took my white, the last thing I did after it was all dry, and I did a white highlight, and I made it curved because the eggs are curved. So if you make that white highlight curve like your egg, it'll make those eggs look rounder. So I put a curve in white on each one of my eggs. Sometimes it was on the side, sometimes it was on the top, but each egg has a curve on it. Then I also added a curve on my wheel down here to highlight my wheel. I put a black dot at the center of this circle because this was my hinge for where the wheel was. And then I put another black dot at the circle because that's where my leg attached. So that's my wheelbarrow. It's fun. It's easy. I think it's going to make a big statement in the yard. I think they're fully stocked on the wheelbarrows at the shop if you want to do a wheelbarrow this next week. I think he's going to be cute. I'm going to put him right beside my gnome, like my gnome's kind of pushing the wheelbarrow, or he's putting the eggs out from the wheelbarrow, because I think that's going to be fun. Now, I think some of you saw that Mary had posted the first section of the nativity set. There's going to be one a month. I'm so excited about that. I think it's going to be so much fun. Mary and I are both going to paint it. Mary's going to do hers in traditional colors. She's going to do the colors that you normally see with Mary. She'll use, you know, a color for the robe and another color for the scarf above her head. And so she's going to use what I would call traditional colors. I'm not going to use traditional colors. And I'm going to show you all just a sneak peek of an inspiration of how I'm going to do my Mary. I just brought a few of them out. But my mother collected the Lennox Nativity set. And they are ivory white. And they have a little bit of gold and a little bit of color on each one. And I know you can't see it on the video, but Mary's robe in here has texture. It has a little fleur-de-lis on the robe here, and along the edge of a robe there is a pattern. And those aren't colored in, but on others, they are. On this angel, it's gold, and it's red and blue. and it all goes all the way around the angel on Joseph. It's right down the center. So I'm going to do my nativity in scarecrow white. It's going to be cream color. All of these robe lines I'll shade in with reindeer brown. And then I'm going to use gold and some color to highlight each part of the robe. So you're going to have more than one option. But when you're thinking about how you want to do paintings and things, take your inspiration from things that are around you, pictures you've seen, pictures that are on your wall. But like when Mary was talking about the nativity and she said, I want to do two different kinds, what can we come up with? I immediately thought of my mom's Lenox nativity set that I inherited from her. They were bought one a month at Foley's. You had to buy, I think Mary and Jesus maybe came together, but the rest of them, you bought one piece at a time over several years. And I think it took us maybe 10 years to complete the set. But I've got elephants and I've got donkeys and I've got cows, but they're all ivory and they all have gold and some other color accents with them. So I think that's going to be a lot of fun every month to have a different piece of the nativity, and then you'll have a whole nativity for your yard. It's going to be a lot of fun. So take a look at the nativity. I think there's some of those in the shop now. They're on the website. But get ready for that. I don't know the date yet that's happening, but it's coming up. So it's something to look forward to. I'm going to be doing a turtle, not in the near future. I can't remember what else is on the calendar, but we're going to have some great things for spring and summer, and then the paint parties. They've got the house just about ready for paint parties. I was over there looking at it the other day, and it's going to be so much fun. I hope those of you that are local can come to some of the paint parties, because I think they're going to be a lot of fun. We're going to have fun painting together. Those of you that aren't local, make a trip over and see us sometime. we'll go out to eat and we'll show you some Texas sights, and you can come and shop at Yard Arts or us and load your car up with blanks and go back home. It'll be a fun road trip. So see you all, I think, in 2 weeks. I don't think I'm on next Sunday night. Never can tell. We might pop on with something, but I'll give you some advance notice. Maybe not a lot like today, but a little bit. But you all have a great week. Maybe going to be rainy and cloudy this week, but have a good week. We'll see you next time. Bye.